Almost all of us can accept that a system tray is pretty useful, and you should probably have one. If you're Microsoft, you might argue it's not actually called a system tray, but you still have one in your operating system. All of us, except for specifically the GNOME project. Now, GNOME has had a really weird relationship with the system tray for a very long time now, completely removing the functionality in the 3.26 release back in 2017, saying in their release notes for that version, GNOME 3.26 no longer shows status icons in the bottom left of the screen. This prevents the status icon tray from getting in the way and is expected to provide a better overall experience. The lack of status icons is not expected to cause serious issues for users. Now, if you've seen forum posts, Reddit posts, videos, and all the stuff about GNOME, you would know there was a lot of users who had very, very serious issues with this feature being missing. They did recommend an extension of the time that restored the functionality. And the reason I say specifically the GNOME project, not GNOME in general, is a lot of downstreams like Ubuntu have been shipping an extension the entire time that restored the functionality. So the only people actually being affected were those on clean distributions of GNOME on things like Fedora and Arch Linux. So if you started on Ubuntu and then swapped over to Fedora, and you know both are using GNOME, a lot of people left completely confused because they didn't realize that Ubuntu GNOME and Fedora GNOME are entirely different beasts. Now, over the years, there have been a number of extensions that have tried to solve the problem because sometimes developers just move on to other things and projects get abandoned. The original one was Top Icons by AG. This is the one the GNOME project originally recommended. And for something that a lot of people are not affected by, that's certainly a large number of downloads, but this is just the start. Following this, people went to another one called Top Icons Plus, which has almost double the amount of downloads. Nowadays, people either use Tray Icons Reloaded or App Indicator and Case Status Notifier Item Support made by the Ubuntu project. This one, 1.8 million downloads. But guys, this is a problem that doesn't affect that many people. Also keep in mind that all of these exist outside the GNOME extension store, usually on a place like GitHub as well. So there's going to be more downloads that aren't being accounted for here than the, 4 million total downloads across just these four extensions, and there were others as well. Now, in just a moment, I'll get to why this one has such a different name to the others, because this actually does relate to the way that system trays work. Earlier, I said the GNOME project just doesn't care about the system tray. This was true up until very recently. They still don't fully care about it, but there certainly was a compromise. 2 years ago, this was opened on the GNOME Shell Extensions repo. This is basically a repo of the officially supported GNOME extensions, include Top Icons extension. That was this one over here. Now, for a long time, basically nothing happened here. But just a few days ago, after waiting almost 3 years for a replacement spec to come around, let's finally land this for GNOME 47. I briefly talked to Alan, who preferred status icons over the original top icons name, so I quickly updated the name and description. Now, if you look through the code, you're going to notice something, or more accurately, not notice something. What does this even support? I don't see any status notifier item slash app indicator support in this extension. Correct. This is leveraging the X-Embed support in GNOME Shell. If we get a better standard at one point, we may support it. But app indicators are not it, and there is no plan on supporting them. Now, like many things in the tech world and many things in Linux, when we say systray, we're not referring to one thing. It might look like one thing to the user, but behind the scenes, there is a lot of weirdness going on. There have been a number of different specifications, all trying to solve the exact same problem. The main ones that we care about, though, are the traditional X11 X embed model and the newer, I say newer in air quotes because it's been around for about 14 years now, status notifier item and app indicator. Now, the original version of the classic approach was authored in 2002 by Havoc Pennington of Red Hat. Now, this was very heavily inspired by what Windows was doing at the time with the Windows XP notification area. Yes, we're talking about Windows XP era specifications. This was never meant to be used the way that it ended up being used. There's a reason it was called the notification area. What it was supposed to be for is for transient notifications. You're using, I don't know, IRC because it's 2002. A message comes in and it's like, hey, you have a message, or you have an email client, you have a new email. There's a system notification, things like that. The way it ended up being used, though, is basically as an applet tray, where you have Discord always present there. You have Steam always present there. Now, there are some cases like OBS, which tells you that you're currently recording, which actually are useful, but most of the other cases are basically just using it to always have the app visible. Now, GNOME and others had various contentions with this approach because, frankly, it just wasn't a great approach. It was fine for the time, it got something working, but things could absolutely be done better. Firstly, most users just don't care about most things that appear in the system tray, so it might be better to provide a way to filter things out. There were a number of accessibility issues with the system tray, one of them being the icons are often just really, really small and hard to click for a lot of users. Also, as the name X-Embed would suggest, the way it works is literally embedding a little X11 window into the system tray area and then generating icons inside of that. This is the way it would also work under Wayland as well. So obviously when Wayland came around in 2008, something better needed to be done. Now, some of these problems are a bit harder to solve than others, and when talking about the small icons, that's still present in the modern solutions. But whilst the main focus has been on App Indicator from Canonical, Status Notifier from KDD, and then X-Embed, the traditional model, there have been a couple of other approaches. We had GTK Status Icon from GTK, and also Status Icon from Linux Mint. 7 years ago, when GNOME dropped the system tray, there was a post from Emmanuel Bussi about why GNOME didn't want to support either the App Indicator or Status Notifier. For Status Notifier, it's a bad spec, and we've been pretty clear from the day it was proposed by KDD developers that it was a bad spec. We suggested ways to improve it, but they were hand-waved because abstraction. Now, when he says hand-waved, what is actually being said here, like in a lot of cases of there is disagreements between GNOME and KDE people, the GNOME people have issues, the KDE people don't see them as issues, they explain why they're not issues, the GNOME people explain why they are issues, and nobody agrees on anything. Nothing gets resolved. Maybe some like grammatical issues here and there and little bits and pieces, but for the most part, when there is a hard disagreement, there is a hard disagreement. As for lib app indicator, it uses dbus menu, which is a pretty terrible way to shove menu descriptions over dbus. It's a hack. Canonical always said it's a hack, and even paid one of the glib/gtk developers to re-implement describing menus over dbus appropriately, which is how GTK applications can export their menus over to GNOME Shell. Also, it falls back to the X-Embed protocol of the old tray icons, which of course cannot really work. Now, absolutely nobody thinks either protocol is perfect, and this article by Tingping does go over a lot of issues with both of them, along with various other protocols that have existed. The main issue with Status Notifier is regarding sandboxing. Each application can register an arbitrary number of Status Notifier items by registering on the session bus the service org.kde.statusNotifierItemPIDID, where PID is the process ID of the application and ID is an arbitrary numeric unique identifier between different instances registered by the same application. This is bad news on a few levels. For one, it requires name ownership in the KDE namespace, which I personally do not understand why. Flatpak blocks all ownership except for your app ID. I'm not even sure a well-known name is required at all. Secondly, it requires putting your PID in the name, which is a no-go for any PID namespace on Linux, as they will almost always have the same values inside the sandbox. Lastly, it has the same issues App Indicator exposes, such as talking to an insecure service, referencing icons by path. It reuses the Dbus menu spec for exporting menus, which is still completely awful and unmaintained. But it's still the best solution we have. And I think this is a good difference between the way that KDE often does things and the way that GNOME does things. KDE is willing to accept, this is not perfect, but we need something that is better than what we had before. Whereas often the case in GNOME world is, we don't want to do anything until we have a perfect specification. And if we don't have a perfect specification, even if the one we have right now is absolutely garbage, we are not going to move until we find something perfectly better. And this is sort of where we're at right now, because the Top Icons extension is still using the classical X-Embed model that was grandfathered into the project back in 2002. So that's something that is already there. But because there was never any agreement on App Indicator and Status Notifier item, that's never going to get implemented into the GNOME project proper. So instead of going down that route and supporting the system that, you know, is actually being used across basically every other desktop now, the solution instead is to revive the old extension that did the X-Embed approach, because, well, we supported X-Embed back then, so I guess we'll just keep using X-Embed until this mythical protocol that nobody is going to work on eventually comes around. Look, I'll give them credit. It is certainly an approach. It's not the one that I would opt for. If I was going to be doing this, I would just say, okay, well, Ubuntu has done the work to implement the modern protocol that everybody else is already using, so I guess we should just adopt what they're using and just make it like a proper part of the extension list. I would like it to be a proper part of the desktop itself, but that's never going to happen. So at least make it a part of the properly endorsed extensions from the project, and then just never talk about it again. But let me know, are you one of the 4 million people not having a serious issue with the lack of a system tray? I would love to know. And are you happy that the system tray is coming back in some sort of form, kinda sort of officially supported by GNOME? Not in the project itself, but in the officially endorsed list of extensions. Or are you just gonna keep using the App Indicator and Status Notifier item one, because that's the one that most people seem to be using anyway? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Subscribe, Stelly, Bearipay, Patreon link in the description down below. I don't know why I did that in different order. That's gonna be it for me, and go GNOME. I don't know.